Hello, dear viewers. Welcome to Allatra TV. For those who join us for the first time, we would like to remind that all live broadcasts that we take, it's taken within the Creative Society project on Allatra International Public Movement platform. The goal of Creative Society project is to ask people all over the world how do they envision Creative Society, a society where each person on Earth feels happy and lives comfortably and prosperity. In order to achieve our main goal, we use the theory of six handshakes and internet. And the theory of six handshakes that said that we all connected through five or less social connections. We invite guests to our programs and they invite their guests and friends and acquaintances, and this creative chain goes on. And in the end of this program, we're going to ask our guest to share a name of one person whom he would like to invite in this live broadcast. And my name is Irina. My co-host today is Lesia. I give the floor to her.
Okay, thank you very much, Irina. And I would like to introduce our today's guest. Mr. Kanu, Ikechukwu Anthony, professor of African religion and cultural studies and president of Association for the Promotion of African Studies. So we really welcome you on our program and happy to see you today with us. Would you please, Mr. Kanu, tell us a little bit about yourself? What do you do and how do you came to it? How did you choose your profession?
Okay, first of all, I am an Augustinian, but beyond being an Augustinian, I am a professor of African traditional religion and cultural studies. I'm also the president of the Association for the Promotion of African Studies and the global president of the World Cultural Studies Research Association. I am a professor of the Department of Philosophy and Cultural Studies at Tansian University, but also a visiting professor to the University of Jos, the Augustinian Institute, and St. Augustine's Major Seminary. I'm also a visiting professor at the Doxia Research Center in India, and the director also of Igwe Research Institute, where I have been researching on the basis of African philosophy, religion, and culture for some years now. And I have chosen the path in which I now work because of my interest in what concerns Africa, not just African history, but more importantly, African culture, philosophy, and religion. This is the basis for my domiciling in my area of specialization, which is African traditional religion and cultural studies. Thank you.
And can you tell us a little more about what you do? You study in a university.
Yes, I studied in several universities. I had my first degree in philosophy at St. Thomas Aquinas Major Seminary, which is affiliated to Urbaniana, Urban University, Pontifical Urban University in Rome. And I had a second degree in religion from the University of Jos. I have a master's in metaphysics, an aspect of philosophy, from the University of Nigeria in Nsukka. And I have another master's in religion and human relations, precisely African traditional religion as specialization, from Nnamdi Azikiwe University here in Nigeria. And I had my PhD from the same university, Nnamdi Azikiwe University. We are also specialized in African traditional religion, after which I now proceeded to the various institutions where I have been visiting and lecturing.
We would like to ask our technical support to show Kalash. And so you would comment on that, where exactly this event took place, what she was saying there. So you were a speaker.
Yes, the first is during our 2018 International Conference on African Ideologies. and Sustainable Development, in which, as a president of the Association for the Promotion of African Studies, I made a presentation. And the second is during our 2019 international conference, in which we reflected on African ideologies and crisis in terms of conflict resolution and the need for peace building. And the other one, as you can see from the awards behind, that was when I was given an award by African Watch for my contribution to the development of knowledge. And so this gives an explanation for the three pictures that you have with you.
Thank you. And we know that you're a professor, so you teach it in university, right?
Yes, I do.
Can you share, please, how do you think it is important to study culture, religion, and traditions of your own country, and to know about different cultures and traditions of people all over the world?
Well, I will begin from why it is necessary to understand a person's tradition and culture. Because Lucky Dube was the man who said that if you do not know where you are coming from, you wouldn't know where you are going to. And there is an African adage that also says that if you do not know where the water is coming from, you will not be able to locate where the water is going to. We also have an African adage that says if you do not know where the water starts beating you, you wouldn't actually know how to help yourself. And so this is just to say that an understanding of a people's cultural foundation is also at the basis of self-identity. Socrates always says, man, know thyself, because he knows that the knowledge of man's self, or the knowledge of a woman's self, who she is, where she has come from, the substratum or the structures that have formed her, actually helps her to become a better person. If a person understands his background, he's able to understand the reasons for his own behavior. He's able to understand the basis for his own worldview. It brings you in contact with your worldview, yeah, which is at the basis of science, actually every aspect of your life.
Yes, I fully agree that it is very important to know who you are and to know the roots and to know the culture in which people around you just and you together, and we all together grow and live. Yes, and I would like to ask you our next question about how this cultural and ethical education can change the vector of the consumer society in which we actually live right now, yes, to more developed creative society. How can this cultural and ethical education help in it?
Yeah, for the past years, I have been developing an aspect of African philosophy, religion, and culture, which is anchored on the Igbo language, which is called Igwebuike. I belong to the school of thinkers who strongly believe that any analysis of situations or circumstances must begin with an analysis of language. And especially from my background as a professor of African traditional religion, I strongly believe that that concept, Igwebuike, which springs from the Igbo cultural society, is at the basis or will form a better foundation for any attempt towards understanding. And the concept which I have often spoken about, Igwebuike, comes from the Igbo language, the Igbo sociocultural group here in Africa. And it emphasizes the importance of complementarity, the importance of relationality, the importance of being together with the other. And it sees a person's existence as being based on the existence of the other persons. In fact, you are because they are. And since they are, therefore you are. That is the basic philosophy behind the word, Igwebuike. And so it emphasizes the need for solidarity, the need for complementarity. And this is ontological in the sense that it is based on the nature of our humanity. that as individuals, we have different needs. But as an individual, we cannot achieve those needs alone. And so you need the other. There is also the understanding that we were all created by the same creator. And that already creates some kind of alikeness in each and every one of us. There is also the need to understand that we have been blessed with different gifts. And so the gift that Irina has is different from the gift that Lesia has. And so for us to really achieve something, we need to come together as Kanu, Irina, and Lesia to be able to achieve something about our future. So this emphasis on complementarity, this emphasis on solidarity, I think is at the basis of any futuristic attempt to understand the future in terms of creative society.
Exactly. Thank you so much for sharing what you say. It's really inspiring. And it resonates to the topic of creative society, which we would like to discuss with you more and ask you a question, which we ask to all people with whom we take interviews. How do you envision creative society, a society in which each person feels happy and feels comfortably?
Yeah, my own concept of a creative society as regards the future is not so much about how much money you have or how much wealth you have amassed or how much property that you have possessed. It's about understanding the concept of human life. How do we understand the human life? Because at the basis of our relationality, at the basis of our complementarity, there is need to understand what we understand as life. What is life for me and what is life for you? It actually affects the way I relate with you. For us to be able to create this society that we all look forward to. And so as a professor of African traditional religion, I will always prefer to begin from an African perspective. And an African perspective that is based on an African language. And for me, that Igwekwike, which I spoke about as a philosophy that is necessary for the creation of our future society, it speaks of what life is. And it centralizes life. Life is a summum bonum. Life is everything. Everything must be based on our understanding of life. And for us here within the Igbo culture, life is described as ndo isi, which means that life is the first. Which means that I must put life first before I put the economy, before I put the other things. Life must come first. And if the economy or politics has any role to play, it is only at the service of life. There is this understanding of life as ndoka, which means that life is greater. Life is greater than wealth. Life is greater than personal interests. What is most important is life. There is an understanding within my own cultural milieu that ndoka ako, which means that life is greater than wealth, which means that a person who possesses wealth does not necessarily have life. A person can have wealth and not have life. And a person could be poor and have more life and peace than a person who has wealth. Here in Africa, we strongly believe that a wealth is not everything. Because we know that wealth can buy you friends, but wealth can buy people around you, but wealth cannot buy you a friend. Wealth can buy you the best mattress, but or the best bed, but it can't buy you sleep. Wealth can buy you the best house, but wealth cannot buy you a home, because there's a difference between a house and a home. Wealth cannot buy you a home. And so that is why the Igbo African speaks of ndokako, that life is greater than wealth. And there is the understanding of life as well as ndubuizu, which means that life is consensus, which means that life is the basis for our coming together. Life is the basis for our discussion, even at this conversation. It is because we have life. And that is why we speak of life, ndubuizu, which means that life is the basis for consensus. I wouldn't have come up on this conversation if I never had life. That is the understanding of ndo amaka, which means that life is beautiful. And if life is beautiful, it must be lived to the full. And that is why I think that we have rallied around to talk about a creative society. Because life is beautiful. And the idea of a creative society is an effort towards enhancing that life, enhancing it further, and making it contemporary, contextualizing it in such a way that it adds meaning. There is another aspect of life within the African context which is very important, and it is the basis for the African way of life. Because you cannot keep God away from the African. African traditional religion has God at the center. And so it speaks of God as the basis for life, God as the source of life. And when an African gives birth to a child, the kind of names they give to the children tells you how they place God within the context of life. They say, Chi Nyerendo, God has given life. Chi Biogo, God is generous in giving life. Chi Wendo, God owns life. It is not owned by a human person. Chijindo, in spite of the fact that he owns it, he does not just own it, but God holds it into existence. Which means that when he moves out of it, then life becomes nothing. So these are the concepts around the African concept of life that enhances and places emphasis on the future of great society, especially as regards the human life. And within the context of great society, we also talk about human rights in terms of freedom. And there is a basis in African ontology for the emphasis on human rights and the freedom. And this ontology is based on the nature of the human person. Here among the Igbo in Nigeria, we refer to the human being as mmad, which means that there is beauty. And the concept of there is beauty is not a concept that keeps God away from man. No, that beauty in the human person is only a participation in the beauty of God, which means that man is beauty. He is mmad because God is mma nowhere. God is beauty itself. And so there is need to understand this as a basis for respecting the fundamental human rights of the human person, of which includes freedom. If you understand that the human person has come as a gift from God, an expression of the beauty of God, one has no option but to give the human person the freedom that he has or that he needs. However, within the context of African ontology, the fact of freedom does not in any way mean that a person has a right to do whatever he wants. No. A person lives within a community, and because you live within a community where your freedom begins, then, or where your freedom ends, the freedom of another person begins. So it does not mean that you are free to do whatever you want. You are free within a community of human beings. And being free within a community of human beings, you must respect the freedom of the other person. Respect the fundamental human rights of the other person. And so the whole idea of the African background in our understanding of a creative society in terms of the human rights of freedom helps you to understand that you pursue your freedom within the context of a community of human beings. And so that brings in the idea of respect, respecting the freedom of the other. And we also talked about, or will I say, within the context of creative society, the importance of human safety. The idea of human safety is fundamental because of the understanding, again, of who the other is in relation to you. We are now moving beyond an understanding or the ontological understanding of who the human person is to an understanding of who a person is in relation to you. And I'd like to come back to the Igbo context, the Igbo ontology. The human person, the other person, is understood as Iben, which means a part of me. When I see a person, if I'm a Muslim, when I see a Christian, or if I see a Hindu, or if I belong to a particular political party or whatever, when I see the other person, I see him or her as Iben, which means a part of me. And when I respect the other person, I am not actually respecting the other person, but I am respecting myself because that person is a part of me. When I look down on the other person, I am not just looking down on the other, but I'm looking down on myself because the other is intrinsically part of me. And so what I do to the other affects me. And so when I create some kind of unsafety for the other, I am invariably creating unsafety for myself. And so when I promote peace for the other, I am also promoting peace for myself because there is an intrinsic connection between me and the other. Without the other, I cannot be within the context of African ontology. I am in existence because the other is in existence. Then the idea of human transparency and openness to information. This brings us back to the Igwe-Buike understanding of leadership. Leadership existing not just as a leader independent of others, but understanding myself as a leader within the context of the people that I have been called to serve. And if I understand it in that way, that I have been called to serve these people, I have been called to serve these persons. When we talk about leadership, it is not just when you are the president of a country or when you are the chairman of a local government or when you are the governor of a state. Even within our families, within the context of our relationships, we express our sentiments, our ideas of leadership. Being able to open up information to others, bring information to others, it helps in building the society. There cannot be a creative society without human transparency and openness to information. Of course, wherever you find lack of openness to information is only a sign of an inadequacy. The inadequacy of our personality, which we are trying to protect by hoarding information. And so these are the major facts that I would like to present within the context of the African ontology and also creative ideology. There is the emphasis on creative ideology. Within the context of Igwe-Buike philosophy, you can't talk about creativity outside of relationship. You are only creative when you relate with others. And your creativity is boosted by the touch of the other person. As I said earlier, we have different gifts. And when I relate with Irina or Lesia, then something happens to my own gift. My gift begins to grow and develop. Because I take something from Irina and take something from Lesia to develop myself. There is none of us who has been able to develop in isolation. We develop and grow in relationship. And so creative ideology begins when I understand who I am, that I am a being in relationship. I am a being awaiting to be complemented. I have a gift that has to be complemented before it can reach its great or height in terms of potential. So you have other ideas of justice and equality, development of personality. Personality development is only successful within a community of human beings. When I understand other person's relation to myself, and then self-governing society and all that. So these are the major issues, self-governing society, emphasizing the importance as well of transparency and openness of information for all. There is a connection between number 8 and number 4. And so this self-governing society is already at the base of Igwe-Buike philosophy. I was talking about Igwe-Buike-Krasi. A kind of a democracy that is embedded in African ontology or within the Igbo context, based on Igbo traditional societies where you have the head of a home not taking a position or not taking a decision without reference to the other members of the family, whether it is a nuclear family or a smaller family, there has to be a discussion. That discussion leads to a consensus. You do not arrive as a decision, as a leader, without discussing with those who are under you. And so the relevance of self-governing society is dependent on the ability of the leader to coordinate the differences in society to be able to produce something wonderful. Actually, where we have problem in terms of leadership is when a leader is not able to coordinate the differences in presence to see how the society grows. So when diversity becomes a problem for a leader, it is a very serious issue. But every leader within the context of Igwe-Buike-Krasi should be able to understand that diversity is the basis of the creative society that we are working towards. Anyone who is not ready for diversity at this point in our history as humanity, such a person is not ready for the future society that we all anticipate. Thank you.
Right, I completely agree with you. And thank you for such a brief review of all our foundations. We usually read them out loud. And thank you so much. You also, in the beginning, you mentioned about the importance of human life, that it should come first, and we completely agree with you. That's why, from all of the foundations, human life goes first. And we would like to read out loud this foundation. Human life is the highest value. Life of any human has to be protected as one's own. The goal of society is to ensure and guarantee that value of each human's life. There is no and never can be anything else more valuable than a human's life. If one human is valuable, then all people are valuable. And I would like to remind our viewers that these foundations are described in article Stages and Foundations of Building Creative Society on ALLATRAunites.com. And we know that Mr. Kanu got familiar and looked through these foundations. And thank you so much for commenting on them and sharing your view on each of them, which is, say, it's really important and inspiring.
I would like to ask Mr. Kanu, do you see the real connection between all these, how do you see it, all these eight foundations?
Yeah, that's if, are you asking if I see any connection between them?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, for me, the connection which I find between among all these eight foundations is first the understanding of the human person as a relational creator, the human person as a being in relation to the other. Because when we are talking about the understanding of the human life, it is not just my own life, but the life of the other. When we are talking about human freedom, I always spoke about the context of human freedom in terms of understanding where your freedom stops and where that of the other person begins. That is the basis for peace. The fact that I have freedom does not mean that I can do whatever I want. So you see the relational character of virtually every point here. It points to the reality of the human person as a complementary being, the human person as a being in relation. And so the human safety, it is not just my safety, but the safety of the other. Transparency and openness of information tells me that I'm in relationship with other persons and I must be open to them. For us to really get a standard society, the creative ideology, creativity boosts. It comes into its flowering stage when I relate with the other person and I take something from the being of the other. And then I complement what I have. Then my creativity is able to get to its zenith. Then the idea of development of personality. Of what importance is the development of personality, if not because I live with others? I develop my personality in such a way that I'm able to fit into a community of human beings and then fit in well, relate better with them. That is why I develop my personality. If I'm alone, I do not need to develop my personality. Justice, equality. Equality means equality in dignity, not necessarily equality in strength, but equality in dignity. That I have the same equality with everyone, either a man or a woman, we all share the same equality. We are all equal as persons. And then self-governing society. It also speaks of relational government, a government that is attentive to the needs of her people. If anybody is into leadership and is not able to govern the society well, it is because the person has forgotten the connection between leadership and followership. There is never a leader without followers. What actually makes the leader are the followers. And so any leader who understands himself within the context of self-governing society as someone who is independent of the persons that he is governing, then such a leader is not a leader. He's only taking a walk, actually. Thank you.
Exactly. I completely agree with you regarding the leader. It's we who shift responsibility to someone else, to politicians, but we all of us can be responsible for the actions of what is going on in our society, and we all can contribute and make something beneficial for society. And I also liked your comment on the development of personality, that each of us should fit into society, so we should work on ourselves in order to talk to other people with a law of kindness and respect to promote this human values. It is really important. Thank you for saying that.
You're welcome.
I would like to ask also one question. In your opinion, how important is it to talk to people and to ask such questions and to ask what do they think about the creative society, how they envision this society, and how they envision the world they would like to live in? Is it important to spread this information?
Yeah, it is very important, because you are not just asking questions and requiring answers that are meant for yourselves. I would like you to know that you are not just having a conversation, but you have developed what I will refer to as a community of inquiry, because people are online and they are learning as well. If I had known of this, I would have been always online to see what new perspectives are coming in, because other people's perspectives also helps me to sharpen mine. Other people's perspectives helps me to grow. And there is no growth wherever there are no questions and answers. We will continue to ask questions and question answers until answers are unquestionable and questions unanswerable. But within the context of our own existence, we shall continue to ask questions. And I think that is the basis of the development of our humanity, because every child that is born asks questions. It is only by asking those questions and the responses the child gets that the child is able to grow. In communities or societies where children are not allowed to ask questions, there is always a problem with the development of the personality of the child. But in places where children are allowed to ask questions, the flowering of the personality of the child knows no bounds. And so we must continue to ask questions, to seek opinions. The world is globalized, and it is globalizing still. There are different perspectives. And what you get from Asia might not be what you will get from America. What you get from America might not be what you get from Europe. And what you get from Europe might not be what you get from Africa. And so there is need to actually get perspectives from different parts of the world, because you are not talking about a creative American society or a creative African society or a creative Chinese society. You are talking about a creative society within the context of the universe, the world. And so you need various perspectives. And I think you have just begun, and you need to go more and get more perspectives from different persons as people continue to enrich. It's a pool of knowledge that you are gathering, a pool of knowledge. And you cannot underestimate what you are doing. You are doing great. Thank you.
Exactly. Thank you. It is important to share opinions and interact in order to make a more open mindset. And I wanted to ask you, in the beginning, you during the conversation, you said several phrases. It was in your native language, right? Your native language is not English, right?
No, my native language is Igbo.
And I wanted to ask you to tell us how will be creative society, or I support creative society, in your native language, in Igbo. Can you pronounce it?
How to speak of creative society?
How to say phrase creative society, or I support creative society, in your language?
Within the context of my language, I will speak of creative society as ebe ntumirikode. Ebe ntumirikode. Which means a society where people are able to go deeper, just beyond the periphery. Because the idea of a creative society is not peripheral. I have heard, I have listened to, I have read different perspectives, and it goes beyond the peripheral. It speaks of unto miracle, going deeper than a society where people are allowed to go deeper from what is normal, to make a discovery of what is at the base of society itself.
Exactly, thank you. And also, as we mentioned in the beginning, we want to ask you about the name of one person whom you would like to invite into this live broadcast and maybe participate together.
Okay, I would like to invite Dr. A.G. Kemowa Ndubisi. Yes.
Thank you very much. I would like to thank you for naming the next guest. And maybe really, as Irina said, that you would like to be a co-host. Thank you so much for today's conversation. It was really great, inspiring, and really got a lot of pleasure. And I would like to thank you once again for being with us and with all the viewers of Allatra TV. And we would like to remind our viewers that about the project Creative Society and the website ALLATRAunites.com. On this website, you can see the join button where you can choose your language and share your vision of Creative Society. If you want to be a guest on our television and or a part of our team, maybe, so please don't hesitate to send us an email. You can see it on the screen right now. And I would like to thank you once again for such an inspiring information, for sincere thoughts that you were sharing with us. It was really really great pleasure to hear you today and to see you with us today, and wish you all the best in your work, and let's stay connected. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye. Yeah, bye.